Hello students, the topic for today is body movements. Now, movement is while doing the physical exercise, whenever our body part moves, then it shows the body movement. So body movement is basically brought about when we have the movement of the bones at the joint. So joint is what? It's a place where two bones meet or where two parts of the body are meeting. Example, elbow, shoulder, neck. And bones are the parts of the skeletal system which are hard and which are made up of strong white tissues. Now the skeleton is basically the framework of the human body and it is what that gives the shape to the human body. Now the skeleton is basically made up of bones, joints and cartilage, and there are around 206 bones present in the human body. Now the technique through which we can check any injury or anything, any defect in any part of the body is the X-ray technique, in which the radiations are passed through the body and they show the shape of the bones in our body. So while an accident or an injury takes place, the doctors, they use this technique to find out any possible injury that might take place to the bones. Now next we are coming to the topic of joint. So joint are basically your movable and the immovable joints. So movable joints, as the name suggests, the joints where the movement is possible. So they are basically of three types, that is your ball and socket joint, pivotal joint and your hinge joint. So ball and socket joint is basically the joint in which a ball-like cavity is rotating inside the socket of another bone, and this type of joint, the movement is possible in all directions. That is a 360 degree movement which is possible, and it is present in your girdle, that is your shoulder girdle and your hip girdle or the pelvic girdle. So pectoral and the pelvic girdle, they have ball and socket joint. Next, coming to your pivotal joint, this joint is present beneath your head and between the first two vertebrae. So the head and the first two vertebrae, they are joined by the pivotal joint or the pivot joint, and it is the joint which allows our head to turn left and right or forward and backward. Next is your hinge joint. So hinge joint is like the hinge of a door, which is allowing only the movement in one plane or one direction. And your wrist, your knee and elbow are the examples of your hinge joint. Similarly, fixed joint, which are also known as the immovable joint. So these joints, they do not allow any bone to move, or in these joints, no movement is possible. So basically, in your skull, we have the immovable joints, and even your upper jaw and the skull, they are also joined by your fixed joint or the immovable joint, in which no movement is possible. Thank you.